Hello and welcome back to our channel for another video. So we did a 3-day trip to Chikmagalur from Hyderabad, and in this video we will be sharing full itinerary for Chikmagalur from our experience. So do watch it till the very end. We will be sharing all the useful tips and details which will help you plan your trip efficiently. So without any further ado, let's get started. Chikmagalur is a picturesque town located in the state of Karnataka, known for its stunning landscapes, lush greenery and pleasant climate. Chikmagalur is referred to as Coffee Land of India due to its extensive coffee plantation. The town is nestled in the foothills of Western Ghats, offering breathtaking views of mist-covered hills, dense forest and cascading waterfalls. We have also uploaded day-by-day video of our trip, and we received lot of questions about which road to take, which are the best budget stay options, and which are the must visit places and which are unexplored places. So we thought of making a dedicated video in which we will answer each and every question, and this will help you to plan your Chikmagalur trip in an efficient way. We have divided this video in few sections based upon your questions, and you can find the timestamps of each section in the description below. This way, you can directly jump to the section that you want to watch. Creating such videos take a lot of time, effort and research. So please subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Now, let's jump right into the first section. First thing I'm going to talk about is the best time to visit this place. Chikmagalur is a beautiful hill station located on Western Ghats. It experiences distinct seasons throughout the year, but the best time to visit Chikmagalur depends upon the traveler preference and their activities of interest. Winter season, which is from December to February, is the peak tourist season in Chikmagalur due to its pleasant weather and clear skies. This season is perfect for trekking, sightseeing and enjoying the natural beauty of Chikmagalur without the discomfort of extreme temperature. But do bear in mind that mornings and evenings can be a bit chilly. We visited during first week of December and we experienced cold and windy weather when we were on top of the hills. Next is summer season, which is from March to May. Summer in Chikmagalur can be relatively warm and dry. Weather can be pleasant in early morning and evening, but midday temperature can be quite hot. This season is not as popular for visiting due to the heat, but it's still suitable if you want to explore the region without any crowd. June to September is monsoon season, which brings heavy rainfall to Chikmagalur, transforming the region into a lush green paradise. Rainfall is quite significant and can sometimes lead to travel disruptions, so it is advisable to check weather forecast and road conditions before planning your visit during this season. Next, during autumn season, which is from October to November, the rainfall decreases gradually and the weather becomes more stable. This season is also an excellent time to visit Chikmagalur, as the weather is pleasant and the surroundings are lush green after the monsoon. Now let's move to the next section, which is how to reach Chikmagalur. The nearest airport to Chikmagalur is Mangalore International Airport, which is located approximately 170 kilometers away. Another is Bangalore International Airport, which is another major airport located around 240 kilometers away. And you can reach Chikmagalur from there via a bus or a taxi. The nearest railway station to Chikmagalur is Kadur Junction Railway Station, which is located around 40 kilometers from the town. There are trains connecting Kadur to major cities like Bangalore, Mangalore, Mysore. If you prefer driving, you can reach Chikmagalur by your own vehicle. The roads leading to Chikmagalur are well maintained, offering a scenic drive through the Western Ghats. You can rent a car or a bike from major cities like Bangalore, Mangalore or Hassan and enjoy the journey at your own pace. We travelled from Hyderabad, which is around 550 kilometers, and it took us about 9 to 10 hours to reach. Moving to the next section, which is the must visit places to cover. Number 1 on my list is Mulayanagiri Peak. This is the highest peak in Karnataka, offering a breathtaking view of surrounding hills and valleys. It is popular among trekkers for its relatively moderate trekking trail and stunning sunrise views. Number 2 on my list is Baba Budangiri Peak. It is known for its scenic beauty and as a pilgrimage site. This place is home to ancient Baba Budangiri Shrine and picturesque Manikya Dhara Fall and offer opportunities for trekking, camping and exploring coffee plantation. Number 3 is Hebei Falls. Hebei Fall is a stunning waterfall located in dense forest, accessible via a trek, offering a refreshing experience amidst nature. We have shared all the required details in our day vlog. Number 4 on my list is Z Point Trek. The Z Point Trek in Chikmagalur is a popular trek that offers stunning panoramic views of surrounding hills, valleys and forests. The Z Point Trek is considered moderately difficult and is suitable for beginners and experienced trekkers. The trail involves ascending through dense forest and rocky terrain with some steep sections. Number 5 is Kudremukh National Park. It is a UNESCO World Heritage Site known for its biodiversity and pristine landscape. It offers trekking trails through dense forest, grasslands and waterfalls. This place is rich in wildlife, including species like tigers, leopards, elephants and various bird species. Number 6 is Experiencing Coffee Estates. Chikmagalur is renowned for its coffee plantation, offering scenic landscape and tranquil ambience. Many estates here offer you guided tours where visitors can learn about coffee cultivation process and enjoy nature walks amidst lush greenery. Number 7 is Bhadra Wildlife Sanctuary. It is a home to diverse flora and fauna, including elephants, tigers, leopards, and rare bird species. It offers jeep safaris, boat rides and trekking opportunities for wildlife enthusiasts and nature lovers. Number 8 on my list is Bhadra Dam, a picturesque reservoir located amid scenic hills and forests, offers fishing and boating activities as well as opportunities for bird watching and picnics. Number 9 is MG Park. This is an offbeat location. This park has many attractions for kids and adults, and it is ideal for picnics and family vacations. You can enjoy train rides, open-air gym, kid zone, artificial caves, tree houses and eateries here. Number 10 on my list is Chinnakeshwara Temple in Vellore. This temple is around 20 to 25 kilometers away from the town. It is a 12th century temple constructed by one of the Hosala kings and is considered as one of the 5 foundations of his legacy. Now moving on to the next section, which is how to travel within the city. The best way to commute is to rent a bike or a car unless you are traveling by your own car. You can rent a bike from the hotel you are staying in or any local rental shop or even from any online rental platforms. You can also get it delivered at the airport and return it at the airport. For this, do carry your original Aadhaar card, driving license and a PAN card, as you need to submit any one document with the car or bike rental agency as a security. Price for a scooty can vary from 300 to 600 rupees per day, and while for a hatchback car, it can vary from anything between 1500 to 2500 per day. Cost for an SUV will be 2500 to 4000 per day here. This cost will vary depending upon the season. Don't forget to make a video of the car or bike before taking the handover, just to ensure that you are returning the vehicle in the same condition as you took it. The major challenge that you can come across in Chikmagalur is network and connectivity, especially when you are trekking away from the popular tourist spots. During our trip, while exploring peaks, the network was not that great. Even for GPS, it is better to always download the offline maps, which you can access anytime. Fifth section is about how to cover the must-visit places in 3 days. On day one, you can start your day after having a breakfast at hotel or take a stop at Siri Cafe for a quick bite. After that, you can cover Baba Budangiri Hills and Manikyadhara Waterfalls. On your journey to Mulayangiri Peak, there are some other attractions like Honamma Waterfall, Jhari Falls and Kavikal Gandhi Viewpoint. If you have sufficient time, you can cover these places. But keep in mind that Mulayangiri Peak involves trekking and it is a must-visit place. So try to complete it before getting exhausted. There will be some eating options along the way, so feel free to take a break in between for lunch. After coming back to the town, you can visit MG Park, but it closes in the evening, so make sure to check the timing before going. For dinner, you can visit town canteen and try their famous butter masala dosa. You can start your day too by going to Hebbe Falls. Since this includes a jeep ride and trekking, it is going to take around 3 to 4 hours. After completing Hebbe Falls, you can go to Z Point Trek, which is a 3 km trek and it will take another 2 to 3 hours of yours. While returning, you can stop at Cafe Coffee Barn. In the evening, you can visit famous Hire Kolale Lake for sunset. Since this place is famous for coffee, you can try a coffee experience cafe like World of Coffee or Panduranga Coffee after that. You can even buy a variety of coffee from here. For day 3, you can start your day by going to Hire Maglore Temple, which is a 1000-year-old temple. After this, you can visit another beautiful temple, which is Chinnakeshava Temple in Bellore. After coming back, you can go to Coffee Museum and visit Ayankere Lake, which is Karnataka's second biggest lake. For dinner, you can come back to MG Road, where you can find variety of restaurants and cafes. By this, you can cover major attractions in just 3 days during your Chikmagalur trip. If you think we have missed any place, then let us know in the comment section. Next, I am going to tell you about stay options. One thing to note is that these prices are as of April 2024 and accommodation prices will vary from season to season. As per our research, we have categorized accommodation based upon 3 categories which you can see on your screens. First is solo travel option, more like bed and breakfast option. Second is the budget stay options. We also opted for a budget stay option. And third is luxury stays. Feel free to pause and note these options or simply take a screenshot for future reference. We stayed at Holiday Inn, which costed us about 2000 rupees per night. We will be sharing a detailed review of the Holiday Inn in our upcoming video. Now let's talk about total cost of the trip. This can totally depend upon how you would like to spend your vacation. First is flight. From Hyderabad to Mangalore, it will cost you around Rs. 4000 per person. Next is accommodation. If you stay at a mid-range or a budget option, you can expect to pay Rs. 2000 to 3000 on an average for a room for one night for two people. One meal at a cafe or restaurant will cost you anywhere between 500 to 800 rupees. For transport, if you hire a scooty, it will cost around 300 to 600 rupees per day. For a 3-day trip, it can cost you anywhere between 10,000 to 12,000 rupees per person. This expense can totally vary based upon the season you are traveling and the choices that you make. That's it from this video. Hope this video will help you to plan your next trip. If you have enjoyed this video, then do like, comment and share it with your friends. Also, if you are new here, then please don't forget to subscribe us. We will be back with another video soon. Until then, happy wandering!